Hey folks, what's up? Jeremy Schaefer here. Check out this origami dragon. This is a model I just designed based on my other dragon, which I taught here. And this one has three claws on each hand and three claws on each foot, and it has an arrowhead tail and pleated wings and eyes, ears, and a mouth, and it's hecka hard. So I don't know how long it's going to take me to teach it to you, but I'm going to give it a shot. So ready, set, here goes. So for this model, I'd recommend using a 10-inch square of Japanese foil, but in the interest of clarity, I'm going to use a 12-inch square of kami. So let's begin colored side up, and let's fold in half. Try to make really sharp creases and crease sharply. And let's unfold and rotate 90 degrees, and let's fold in half in this direction. And now let's unfold and let's fold this edge to the crease. And unfold and let's fold the edge to this crease. And unfold and rotate 90 degrees counterclockwise, and let's fold this edge to this crease. And unfold and let's fold this edge to the crease. And unfold, and let's rotate 45 degrees counterclockwise, and let's fold diagonally in half. And unfold, and rotate like this, and let's make this fold, and let's make this fold, and pinch the corner like this, and let's bring it down like, and let's flatten it up like this and bring it down. And bring it up and open the pocket and squash it. And now we're going to squash this flap. So fold it up and down. And now let's open the pocket and let's squash it, making sure that this crease lands on the middle. Okay, and now let's fold this edge to this edge, just the top layer. Like that, and unfold the flap. And now let's fold this flap down like this. And now let's do the same thing on this flap. So let's fold it back and forth and make it stick up, open the pocket, and let's squash it. And let's fold this edge to this edge. And unfold, and let's fold this flap up like this, and let's rotate. And now let's fold this corner to this corner. And unfold. And now we're going to make a petal fold. So let's fold this point, this corner down, and we're going to push on the sides so that the two edges come together, and let's flatten. And now let's fold this edge to this edge. And same thing on the left side. And unfold both flaps. And now let's open here, and we're going to make a little mountain crease right on this edge, just like that. And the same thing here, just make the crease, and let's bring these two points down and flatten. Okay. Now let's fold this flap over like this, and let's zoom out and rotate. And now we're going to fold this edge to the top. Make sure that it is exact. And over here, we're going to fold it up and just pinch at this corner right here and flatten it down like this. Okay, and let's rotate and let's do the same thing here. So let's first fold this flap over like this, and let's fold this edge to here. And let's pinch this corner and let's flatten it like this. And now let's turn over, and we're going to fold in half in both directions. So fold like this in half, and unfold and rotate, and fold in half in this direction. Unfold, and let's turn over right to left, and we have a diagonal fold right here. We need a diagonal fold here, so let's fold diagonally in half in this direction. And unfold, and let's turn over top to bottom. And now we're going to make a preliminary base. So push the middle in and bring all of the corners down like this. And crease everything sharply. And now we're going to make sort of a bird base. So let's fold this edge to this crease. And same thing on this side. Let's fold this edge to this edge. And let's turn over and let's fold this edge to the crease. And you can also fold this little flap in as well. And the same thing on the right side. Okay, and let's rotate. And let's fold this edge to here. And unfold, and let's fold this edge to here. And unfold, and now we're going to fold this flap up on this point right here. So make sure that this crease aligns with the crease behind it right here, and this crease aligns with the crease behind it. Like this. And now let's fold this corner down, aligning with these two edges. Okay, and let's unfold and let's unfold these two flaps and turn over and unfold these two flaps and rotate. And now we're going to double sync this flap on this crease and this crease. So let's open the square base up. Just stick your hand inside and let's turn over and let's make mountain folds right on this little square here. So I have my hand inside and just pinch right along this little square. Like that. So we have the square of mountains. And now let's turn back over. And now we're going to make this square that goes around here. Okay, so now we're going to reform the square base, so bring the corners together and push it in, but we need this point to push back up. So if it doesn't push up, then you just need to reach in and push that middle point up. So it looks like that. So this is what it looks like inside. Okay, and let's flatten and let's rotate. And zoom in. And now let's fold this flap up like this and fold like this and turn over and do the same thing on this side, right on the creases. And rotate 180 degrees. And now we're going to petal fold. So let's first fold this flap down. Give ourselves a nice crease. And let's lift the flap up and flatten it on the existing creases. Okay, and let's turn over and let's do the same thing on this side. So let's fold this flap down and back up, and lift this flap up, and petal fold it. Okay, and now let's make a mountain fold right on this flap, right on the existing creases. So we're just folding right along this crease, but going through all layers of the flap. And now let's fold it down. So we're going to fold this edge to this crease, and that will make a new fold right in between, right there. Okay, and make sure it aligns perfectly and flatten. Okay, and now let's turn over right to left and let's fold this flap down, and we want to align it with these two edges. We just want the front and back to align, to match. And now let's fold this flap up right on this crease. Okay, now let's fold this flap to the left. And turn over, and let's fold this flap to the left. And here you can fold this whole thing in half like this. Okay. And now let's fold this flap up like this. And we're going to do the same sort of thing that we did on the other two flaps. Here we have this crease. So just on this flap, let's continue this crease to the left. Let's just extend it like that. And now we're ready to do the same thing. Let's fold this down to here, making the fold in between. Okay, and let's turn over right to left and do the same thing on this flap. So let's fold it up. And here we have our existing crease, and let's extend it to the right. And let's fold this edge down to here. Okay, and try to make sure that all of your folds align. Okay, and now let's fold this edge to here. And unfold, and let's fold this edge to here. And unfold, and let's rabbit ear. So let's pinch here and bring it up, and let's collapse it to the right and to the left and to the right again. Okay, and let's turn over top to bottom. And let's do the same thing on this flap. So let's rotate and let's fold this edge to here. And unfold and fold this edge to here. And unfold and let's pinch here and rabbit ear it. And let's collapse it to the right. Oops, make sure that it's folded nicely. And to the left. And back to the right. I'm just trying to fix up this like that. Okay. And now let's bring it back to the left again. Okay, now let's rotate. And now we're going to make a reverse fold with this flap. So let's turn it over and let's bring it down like this. So what we want is we want this edge to align with this edge and make the fold right here. And we want this edge to align with this edge and make the fold right here. Okay, this is going to be the tail and this is going to be the head. So let's do the same thing. We're going to reverse fold this and make these edges come together. And these edges come together. Okay, and let's fold these wings down. And now we're going to thin out this flap. So let's fold this edge to here. And it can go through all layers of this flap like that. And let's fold this edge to here and flatten. Okay, let's turn over and do the same thing over here. So let's fold this edge to here. And fold this edge to here and flatten. Okay, now let's do the same thing on the tail. So fold this edge to here. And this edge to here. And flatten and turn over and fold this edge to here. And this edge to here. And flatten. Okay. Let's work on the wings. So let's rotate and let's fold this crease to this edge. Like this. And let's flatten, forming this fold right here. And let's rotate and let's fold this flap like this. And now we're going to fold this flap up right on this point, and we're aligning these edges. And now let's fold this flap up right on this edge. And crease sharply. And now let's unfold and unfold. And now let's fold this edge to this crease. And unfold. And now we're going to fold this crease to this crease. And unfold. And now let's fold this flap up right on this crease. And let's rotate. And let's form this fold right here on this crease. And we're going to bring it up to this edge. So we're making a new fold in between. Like that. And let's do it again with the next crease. So let's form the fold. And let's fold this up to here. And flatten, making the new fold. And let's do one more time. Let's make this fold and fold it up. All right, now let's pull this flap out like this. And let's fold right between these two points. Like that. And let's unfold. And let's stick this flap inside. Like that. And let's wrap this flap around the edge. And unfold. And let's fold this flap inside also, like that. Okay. And let's flatten it. And rotate, and let's continue making these pleats. So let's form this fold and fold this up to here. And let's fold this edge to here. Okay, so we have all the pleats done. And now let's make reverse folds on all five of these points. So here we go. Let's fold this edge to here. So we're bisecting there. And now we're going to fold this edge to here, this edge. So we're bisecting right here. And there it is. And now let's do that four more times. So here and here. And here. And here. And now comes the thick ones. Here. And here. And here, and here. Okay, so there is the wing. And let's flatten it again. And now let's fold this to here. And let's make a fold from this point to the corner. Like that. and let's flatten it up. And let's rotate. And now let's fold this flap behind on these two points. So let's mount and fold it like this. All right, there it is. And now let's turn over and let's make this wing. So let's fold this crease to here. And let's flatten it down, forming this fold right here. And let's fold this down and fold this flap on this point so that this aligns, and fold it up like this. And unfold and unfold. And let's fold this to this crease. And unfold, and let's fold this crease to this crease. And unfold, and let's fold on this crease. And rotate, and let's form this fold and fold this up to here. And form this crease and fold it up to here. And form this crease and fold it to here. Unfold this flap and let's fold this up right between these two points and unfold the flap and stick it underneath and unfold this flap and wrap it around the edge and unfold and stick it inside and rotate. And let's fold this crease, make it a mountain fold, and bring it up to here. And let's fold this edge up to here. And now let's make our reverse folds. And the last one. And rotate. And let's fold this to here. And fold this flap up from this point to here. And flatten it. And now let's fold this flap behind between these two points. like this. And flatten. And our wings are almost done. At least we can go on to the tail now. So let's zoom out. And let's open this. Let's first bring these legs out of the way. Let's bring them to the front. And same thing on this side. Okay, and now let's open this pocket. And let's make a mountain fold. We want to make a mountain fold about like this. We want the mountain fold to be, this mountain fold to be perpendicular to the crease, and we want this length to be about the same as this length. So it's like that, and unfold. And now let's fold this corner to almost, well, about like that. It doesn't need to be exact. It's not exact. And let's unfold it, and let's reverse the crease so that it's a mountain fold. And now we're going to make another mountain fold between these two creases. And so fold it. And make the creases line up. And unfold. And now let's fold between these two creases. And unfold. And let's fold between these two. Make a new mountain fold. And unfold. And now we're going to make these creases into pleats. So here we have the mountain, and the valley fold goes right above it. It's about a couple millimeters, maybe. Like that. So this is what it looks like that. Okay, and we're going to do the same thing on the other four creases. And so form the fold and bring it up. And form the fold and make the pleat. And two more, and the last one. Okay, that's what it looks like from the side. Okay, now let's unfold, and let's try to flatten it. Okay, and let's fold the tail like it was. And now we're going to crimp the tail. So let's rotate, and holding like this, we're going to just bend the tail up. You want to push the paper up, but you want to avoid folding on this edge here because you might tear the paper. So just make a little crimp like this, and the crimp should end about right here. That should keep the paper from tearing. And this is what it looks like from inside. Okay, and let's do the next one. So just a little crimp like that, and I'm trying to stop the crimp short of this edge. Okay, next one. So they're just really tiny, like that, and two more to go. And now for the last one, let's make the full pleat that was in the paper. So open it up and make the pleat. And now let's open this up and look at the underside. And now we're going to reach in and pull this layer out like this and flatten it down so that it looks like this. And the same thing on the right side. So we're reaching in, getting this layer, and we're reforming it. So we're changing this fold. We're bringing it further out like this. And the guideline for it is that we want, I'm going to just wrinkle fold this to make it a little bit cleaner looking. We want this to be a diamond. So let's fold this corner down here. Like that. And now let's unfold and let's reverse fold right here. Let's make this fold and this fold right on the edges. And let's reverse it like that. And now we're going to reverse it again. So we're folding right on this edge and on this edge. You've never seen my finger so close, have you? I hope I'm not scaring you. Okay, and now let's open this up and let's fold on this crease. By the way, this is a new camera. This is pretty cool. It's like totally micro. And now we're going to squeeze right here and right here. Okay. And let's fold this down like this and like this. So we're just sculpting the arrowhead. You can maybe round it a little bit. Okay, so there's the tail, and now let's work on the head. We can fold these back down for now. So it's similar to the tail, but there's a few more layers, so it makes it a little bit more difficult. So let's fold these down, and let's make our mountain fold. So open up here, and we want to fold this down and try to make it so that the mountain fold is such that this length is equal to this length, and it's perpendicular to this crease. Okay, and now let's make another mountain fold about right here. So it looks like that. Maybe, I don't know, just estimate about like this. I don't really have a guideline for that fold. Okay. Now let's make another mountain fold right in between these two mountain folds. So make them line up and unfold, and let's make a mountain fold between these two. You can just eyeball it. And between these two. and unfold. And now let's make the pleats. So we have the mountain and the valley is right above it. Like that. And as you're making these pleats, really try not to make this fold, because when you make that fold, you risk ripping the paper. It might rip anyway, but I'm just giving you a tip of how not to rip it. So now let's do the second pleat. And the third. And the fourth. And the fifth. Okay, and zoom in a little bit more on this. So just make all the pleats nice and sharp, being very careful not to tear the middle crease. Okay, that's what it looks like from the side. And now let's unfold them and flatten it. And you really want these flat before trying to make that crease, because otherwise you will tear that paper. I have torn it on numerous occasions, and I learned. Okay. All right, now let's fold it like it was and get the arms out of the way. And now let's make our crimps. And once again, just make little crimps. They don't need to extend all the way to this edge. In fact, they shouldn't, otherwise you'll tear the paper. Okay, that's the first crimp. And next one. And the next one. And next. And the last one. Okay, so that's fair. And okay, now let's work on the head. So very carefully, let's make an outside reverse fold. Really try not to tear the paper. So it's like that. Okay, and let's bring this ear back, and bring this ear back. And now let's fold this edge to this edge. We're making the eye right now. And turn over, and let's fold this edge to here. Okay, and now we're going to rabbit ear on this flap. So let's just pinch this like this. And collapse it up like this. And turn over. Let's do the same thing. Let's rabbit ear this flap. So pinch right here and bring it up like this. Okay, so now let's try to make this point stick out more. So let's just pinch it like that so that it sticks out. And same thing on this side. Let's grab it and open it and just pinch it like that. This is what it should look like from underneath, or at least what it does look like. I don't know if it should. I'm gonna just fix this up a little bit by flattening it like this. Okay, there it is. And now let's shape the snout. So let's push it down like this. And now just open the mouth, just separate the two points and open it like that. And now get a pin, because there's some eyes that can be opened, but not with my hands. At least maybe your hands can. So just open the pocket, and there's one eye. And open the other one. And those are the two eyes of the dragon. And now just shape it to taste. Let's curl this bottom part down like this, if you want. And I'm going to just fold this top part like that and close it up a little bit so that it stays. Make sure the eyes stay open. And yeah, now it's just about shaping. I'm gonna narrow the snout a little bit. Give it a forehead, try to anyway. And there is the dragon head. Okay, let's zoom out. And let's make the claws. Let's start on the legs. Zoom back in. Okay, let's fold this leg forward right on this crease, using this crease as a guide. Unfold. Okay, what we're going to do now is reverse this point right here. So let's fold this to here, and let's fold this to here, like that, and flatten. And now let's unfold it, and we're going to open it up, and we're going to refold it so that this crease goes to here, and this crease goes to here. So it's like that, And like that. And now let's reverse it right on the crease there and there. And now let's fold this edge to here and this edge to here. And try to make it come to a point there and there. Okay. And now let's do the same thing here. So let's fold this to here. And fold this to here. Bisecting these two angles. And unfold. And now let's fold up like this so that this crease hits this edge and this crease hits this edge. And reverse it again on the crease. And let's reverse it one more time. So this edge goes to here. And same on the little claw right there. Okay. And so there you have it. And let's do the same thing on this one. So I'm going to fast forward this. I hope you get it by now. Okay, like that. And now let's rotate and let's fold this paw forward on this crease like that. And same thing on this side, we already did. Okay, like that. And now let's rotate the tail. Rotate it up like this. That way it'll form the legs right here. Okay, and you can just now shape the claws to taste. And on this side. And maybe separate them a little bit and try to make them individual. Okay. And it stands. Let's get to the claws. Okay, so now what we're going to do is the same sort of thing, but on these, let's just fold, make the reverse fold like that. So we're folding this to here, and this to here, and let's fold this to here. I know I kind of messed it up a little bit, but, and this to here. And now let's open this up like this, okay, and fold this down or up, whatever, and let's rotate. And now let's fold this corner, let's fold it back up to these points. That way the claws will be the same length. And let's fold this point behind, matching up with this edge. And let's fold this be- behind, matching up with this edge, and fold it in like that. Okay, and now let's fold this whole thing down, just down like this, as far as it goes naturally. And now let's fold this edge to this edge. And now let's try to mountain fold this whole flap. Just squeeze it, basically. Forget mountain fold, just shape it. But I am trying to make a mountain fold right like that. And again, just grab it and shape it and squeeze it. And now let's separate the claws. And you can shape them to taste. Be careful not to rip right in here. And kind of curve them. Like that. Okay, and this claw is done. Let's turn over and do this one. And I'm going to fast forward this. Open here and fold this up like this and rotate and fold this corner to here and fold this behind like that. And this behind, and close it back up, and now let's fold this down, and fold this forward, and now just squeeze it and try to narrow it. Okay. And now separate the claws. This can be the thumb and curve them. Just shape them to taste. All right, and now let's zoom out. And now basically it's just time to shape to taste. So I'm gonna just bend it, just curl it in like that. And same thing on this side. Okay, and pull the wing out. Like that. And now I'm going to shape this neck. And be careful not to tear it. It's really hard not to. I managed to this time, but I tore a lot on my rough drafts. And now I'm going to put a little bit of curvature on the neck. You might want to first try with the tail. It's a little bit easier because it's less layers. And when you make these pleats, when you make the crimps, try to keep them crimped as you curve it. That. Okay, and on this side. And it doesn't need to go straight. In fact, it looks nicer if it goes off to the side a little bit, maybe. Okay, looks good. And now let's try for the neck. I like holding the front of the neck so that it doesn't tear. Just pinching the front. As I make the curvature. And on this side. Okay, now that I have a little bit of curvature, I'm going to just kind of squeeze it and hope for the best. And spread out the wings. And there is the Super Deluxe Dragon. And this is one of my longest videos. As you can see, it was a super challenge. So there it is. It stands. You can fiddle with it. And just shape it to taste, and there it is, the Super Dragon Deluxe. Well, I hope you didn't die And whoever's still watching this video, wow, you are diehard. This was a marathon of a video. And if you ended up with something even slightly resembling this, well, congratulations. This is a difficult model. And it's not even an action model. Or yeah, sure, it is an action. It flies. It hops. It falls down. And it crawls. And it will eat the camera. All right. See you guys later. Bye-bye.